The ring. You see, so I assumed that either I had been married at some time or I was still married. When you can't remember your own name, how are you supposed to start searching?
Actually, you've had two wives.
I beg your pardon?
Well, I never met your first wife. She died before you moved to Erinsborough.
Oh. So this...
No, I gave you that. We're still married. Well, I assume we are. I never remarried, did you?
I don't know. Not that I'm aware of. So, we both lived in Erinsborough together?
Yeah, in Ramsay Street.
Number 24.
Yes, that's right. Apparently Marlene Kratz lives there now.
Oh, dear. Well, then Marlene should have been back here ages ago.
Oh, don't worry. She's in the pub with Helen.
Oh, no.
Oh, relax. She's not a booze artist. Neither is Helen. We were to have this reunion in the bar, but you threw a spanner in the works.
This is all so very confusing.
You want to call it a day?
No. I must know about my past.
Well, I'm game if you are, Harold. Look, what do you want me to call you?
Well, if I really am this Harold Bishop, I suppose I better get used to the name, eh?
I'm glad. Somehow I can't see you as a Ted.
It's the name they gave me in rehab. You see, my very first memory, and this is a very vague one, is being revived on board a fishing trawler.
Don't you remember how you got in the water?
No, I'm afraid not. I've tried.
I suppose you wondered why nobody looked for you.
Yes, I did. Oh, for years I did. And then I just had to assume that I didn't have any family or friends.
Oh, Harold, that's not true. We just thought you were dead. And now you're here. I can't believe it. How did you get to Tasmania?
Oh, well, you see, my theory is that the trawler that picked me up was fishing illegally. Because, you see, they just dumped me on shore and took off.
Oh, charming.
Oh, well, no, they did save my life, you see. Anyway, I just kept walking until somebody picked me up. Dear, I must look dreadful. They took me to a hospital.
But it's strange that the police didn't put two and two together. I mean, somebody reported missing and then you turning up. Oh, well, I suppose no one in Tasmania is going to recall a report of somebody washed off the rocks on the mainland.
Well, if I'd have had some identification, I suppose they would have known where to start. As it was, everyone was convinced that I was a local, including myself.
How did you get back here?
Oh, what a coincidence. I was at the rehab, trying to regain my memory. And that's when I met the Silvers. I was working in the kitchen there, you see.
That'd be right.
the big one?
I'll explain later. Go on.
Anyway, my doctor thought it would be a good idea for me to have a fresh start in a new environment. And you see, the Solvos had several vacancies on the mainland, and for some reason I chose Erinsborough. Well, of course, now I know why.
Of course.
Tell me, did I have some experience with kitchens before Max's?
You sure did.
Yes, well, of course, you see, because cooking always came so naturally to me.
You were a wonderful cook. Oh. In fact, you used to run this very coffee shop.
Really? Mm-hmm. I just don't recognize a thing about it.
Oh, well, it's had a bit of a revamp since you ran it. I wouldn't worry about it.
All right. Except for the first time I saw you. That was totally different. It's like driving through a thick fog. You suddenly see a familiar landmark. And then it just fades away. And you can just hope that you're going in the right direction. And have I changed very much? I mean, am I anything like the Harold you remember?
You haven't changed a bit. A little bit more grey, perhaps. A few more worry lines here. And you really should keep an eye on that tum.
Oh.
But underneath, you're still the same person. Kind, gentle. Still beautiful.
I just can't believe that we're married. Oh, I'm sorry, that didn't come out the way I intended. Oh, dear. I think I'll leave that sandwich.
So you started eating meat again?
Hmm?
Well, you used to be a vegetarian.
That is astounding.
Why?
Well, I was just saying to Marlene how I intended becoming a vegetarian.
Oh, there you go, then nothing's changed.
Look, Madge, I have to get back to work.
Yes, I know. Listen, could we meet again? I mean, I'll quite understand if you don't want to.
No, no. No, I want to see you again. Goodbye.
I'll ring you.
Thanks for coming to the rescue.
Oh, Helen, I'm sorry. I haven't even asked how you are.
Oh, I'm fine.
I'm afraid today's knocked me sideways. I thought I was prepared for everything, but...
Yes, well, seeing Harold must have been a bit of a shock.
Yeah. The worst thing was him not recognizing me. My husband, the man I'd lived with and loved, treating me like a stranger. Oh, it broke my heart.
Oh, Philip, Madge is staying with us for a while.
No, I don't want to cause any trouble.
Pleasure to have you.
I spent the whole day trying to keep cool. I remember what you said about your first meeting. I didn't want to scare Harold off.
I'm sure you didn't.
Well, he wants us to meet again.
That's encouraging.
I'm determined to bring him back, Helen. Lead him away from Ted and back to Harold. I know it'll take a long time, but I am not going to give up. Until he remembers what we meant to each other. I want my husband back.